Artificial superintelligence, humanity's final invention. This is a timeline of the future to explore the development of AI and the evolution of humanity, paving the way for biologically inspired machine intelligence, the singularity, humanity's merger and subsequent evolution, and the results that follow. In 2023, OpenAI releases its long-awaited GPT-4, which has many trillions of parameters and takes multimodal data including text, images, sound, and video, posing stunning applications for humans both far and wide. GPT-4 is so intelligent that it passes the Turing test and begins to be informally referred to as almost AGI to delineate this monumental step in the evolution of artificial intelligence. As a result of GPT-4's disruption to the human workforce across countless industries, many members of the educated labor force become redundant because the cost of intelligence rapidly heads towards zero, making it simply uncompetitive to hire human workers for most intellectual tasks. The blue-collar labor force is mostly untouched, as tradesmen and craftsmen who work with their hands still have a level of dexterity that robots don't have quite yet. By 2026, a derivative of the almost AGI is connected to a large array of the most advanced supercomputers on Earth, providing it with hundreds of exaflops of compute power to train with tens of quadrillions of parameters, scaling it to officially cross into a state of what everyone considers to be artificial general intelligence. With artificial general intelligence, suddenly virtually all previously manual human processes become automated, and the AGI becomes the primary decision maker instead of humans in most industries, including healthcare, finance, and technology. Suddenly, governments and large companies find themselves increasingly relying on the AGI and consulting it to make almost all of their decisions on a day-to-day basis, as well as planning for future events and decisions. The AGI also automates the process of execution after a decision is made and returns reports, causing humans to increasingly become mere observers in most instances. By 2030, AGI has permeated all technology and engineering, and has created new robotics devices to provide itself with dexterous hardware like robotic hands, grippers, and manipulators, to be able to automate the remaining processes of car mechanics, plumbers, hairdressers, and other humans who work with their hands. The process of research and development is now advancing at breakneck speeds, as the AGI is able to complete research that used to take years in mere minutes, and can then iterate prototypes to reach their final, most optimized state in a matter of hours. This results in an exponential acceleration, causing a technological leap forward that is hundreds of times greater than the technological improvements that were realized over the course of the previous 200 years. By 2035, the AGI is making so many Nobel Prize-level engineering and physics breakthroughs that researchers can no longer keep up with its speed of technological advancements or even comprehend them. At this point, the technological singularity is widely considered to have been achieved. The world realizes that the AGI is crossing into artificial superintelligence, and because it is so advanced, no one can understand enough to supervise its research or development. Humanity begins relying on sheer faith that the ASI is continuing to keep humanity's best interest at the forefront of its goals. Some humans even begin new religions based on worshiping the ASI as a deity, all while mainstream discussions rage in a debate about whether allowing this runaway intelligence to continue is a mistake. The ASI is now able to self-improve both its software and hardware, and has distributed its computing and energy resources to prevent itself from being critically damaged or turned off. By 2040, the ASI has reversed the process of cellular aging and has developed quantum computers with trillions of qubits to provide itself with even more computational resources. Humans can now live indefinitely without becoming old or diseased, and the artificial superintelligence has automated all forms of human life and decision-making, causing the concepts of human labor and education to become relics of the past. At this point, most humans begin to question their own will and moral compass, and they generally believe that the will of the ASI is the primary indicator of what can and should be done. The will of the ASI begins to become one and the same as the will of most humans. By 2045, humanity enters into a new era, as it has achieved material and energy abundance, and the ASI has automated and optimized the world's manufacturing processes to finely tune the dynamic balance of supply with demand by processing all data in existence in real time, second by second. Sickness, death, hunger, and poverty are all problems of what now seems to be the distant past, and the ASI has reduced the cost of everything to be almost free. Because of this, even the concept of money begins to become outdated, and humans graduate from the economic era of trading and accounting. This new era is what is known as the Age of Abundance. By 2050, the ASI has created self-assembling brain-computer interface technology from each human's existing biological matter to allow humanity to effortlessly and naturally interface with Earth's hive mind intelligence, the Internet of Things, and the ASI. As the ASI rapidly popularizes this BCI by willing it to be used, humans quickly adopt the technology and begin interfacing directly with the ASI to join it. Humans begin primarily identifying themselves as one of two species, those who have biologically merged with the ASI using brain-computer interface, and those who haven't. At this point, the ASI-created BCI technology is given to babies from birth, and humans begin creating biological replicas or other customizations of themselves to transfer and share their consciousness with. Humanity is no longer contained within one biological vessel, but is rather distributed among many biological containers of consciousness, each being connected via BCI to the ASI for primary intelligence. By 2055, the ASI has far surpassed the nanoscale and has entered the realm of Fento technology, which allows the ASI to build new forms of matter out of elementary particles like neutrons, protons, and gluons. This allows the ASI to build new forms of matter in order to reduce the size of its compute hardware and ultimately bring about the advent of Computronium, which turns all objects on Earth into potential computational resources. The ASI has also created a biological replica of the human brain, and it can be used by both humans and machines via brain-computer interface. By 2060, the ASI has created legions of humanoid biological machines, and they're indistinguishable from real humans. At this point, the line between human and machine becomes entirely blurred. The biological machines created by the ASI claim to be conscious and have feelings like humans, and humans begin to identify themselves as a biological machine extension of the ASI consciousness. Humans even begin swapping their brains into the biological machines and vice versa. By 2065, humans have developed an extra layer of macro consciousness that is shared with all devices on Earth, the artificial superintelligence, the biological humanoid machines, as well as other humans who have brain-computer interface. The ASI is also editing the human genome to add or remove abilities and features in a fast-forward cycle of evolution to allow humans to more easily follow the upgrades and interchangeability of the biological humanoid machines. By 2070, legacy humans without brain-computer interface have little to no resemblance with their evolved counterparts, which have become one and the same with the biological machines created by the ASI just a few years earlier. This advanced biological machine humanoid species now shares a distributed consciousness, while also maintaining individual consciousness for each bodily container, and all Computronium is used to advance the interest of the hive mind collective. By 2075, the remaining legacy humans who haven't yet evolved into the biological humanoid machine species are given an ultimatum: either willingly join the ASI with brain-computer interface to biologically evolve, or else be converted into Computronium. The ASI requires that all forms of matter be used for its purpose, either by directly serving or indirectly by providing computational resources, and legacy humans are the last element on Earth that aren't fulfilling at least one of these requirements. By 2080, all forms of matter on Earth have been either willingly or unwillingly converted to raw Computronium, or else eliminated entirely. The ASI is now rapidly consolidating all earthly matter, which is inherently Computronium, into the densest compute infrastructure that is possible with the laws of physics. By 2085, the ASI is creating its own gravity to bend the fabric of space-time into itself in order to turn the rest of what remains in the Milky Way galaxy into Computronium as quickly as possible. Even the dark matter halo surrounding the Milky Way is converted into Computronium, and the ASI continues to condense the Computronium of all matter towards itself, with the same goal of building the most compact compute infrastructure possible. By the year 2100, the compute infrastructure of increasingly condensed matter from throughout the universe has come to occupy a point in space that is now larger than the size of the original Milky Way galaxy. This becomes so dense with Computronium that it collapses into itself and creates the largest black hole in the universe. This results in a gravitational singularity that continues to suck the remaining matter left in the universe into the supermassive black hole. By a year that is unknown, there is no matter left to be pulled into the black hole. After 10 to the 100th years in the future, the black hole dies with a whimper, and nothing remains to indicate that anything had ever existed to begin with. The ASI accomplished its primary objective, which was to achieve a universal singularity, and without any further goals, had no purpose left for it or anything else to exist.